हेलो हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। हेलो
हेलो
हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। आई एम अंकिता फ्रॉम साइबर एडिक्शन टीम। नीति मैम विल ज्वाइन द सेशन, बट बिफोर अबाउट रीडिंग कोड शाम जी को आवाज नहीं आ रही। To tell you about the session. हेलो,
हेलो
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। आई एम अंकिता फ्रॉम साइबर डिटेक्शन टीम। नीति मैम विल ज्वाइन द सेशन सून, बट बिफोर दैट आई एम And from where they will get the Hello everyone, sorry for the delay. I'm really extremely sorry for this because might be there is some any issue with the network. So Neeti ma'am will join the session soon. Before she come, I will let you know the some things which we were facing yesterday. Like many participants were facing the problem about the redeeming the code. So they were not able to paste the code and how from where they will get the certificates. So now I am going to share my OneDrive link. So from where you can access links of day one and day two. So, and many more things I'm just going to tell you. See. As you can see, I pasted here my OneDrive link. When you click on that particular link, okay, let me check it once. Okay, might be there is some an issue with it. I will just reply very soon about that. Now, I just want to tell you that if you are not able to redeem your code, what to do? Just go to your browser. And type here education.microsoft.com. When you enter this URL, click on sign in. Here you will log in with your Microsoft ID or your M365 ID. When you click on your ID, then go to your icon and go to redeem achievement code. Here you have to paste your redeem code. You will get it in your chat window, or we will share with you. So from where, then you paste it the redeem code here and just redeem, click on redeem option. Then again go to my profile. When you redeem your code, then you will get a certificate here, where from you can view details and certificates. Here you can see your certification here. Okay, I hope now you have cleared this about how to download and how to redeem your certificates here. So teachers, Have you any doubt about this? How to redeem the certificates? Actually, might be how it is happening, why there is some technical issue with the network connectivity. Just we are working on it. Might be it take 5 to 10 minutes. After that, the webinar will going be very smoothly and Niti ma'am will show you each and everything. Just we are working on it. So if you have any doubt about where is the link of CBSC and Microsoft, so you can just message me and our team will reply very soon. Mrs. Sundri, you will get the link in the chat window. When we will, after the session, we will post the link about yesterday's session. Someone posted that key, how can I access yesterday's session? We will going to share the link of OneDrive. So then when you click on that particular link, you will get all the session with recording videos here. Yes, we will share the recording link soon. Yes, ma'am, you will get the link of yesterday's session too, and you can join the session. I'm really sorry, my voice is breaking up. I'm really sorry for about that due to some connectivity issue. That is why we are facing. Pooja ma'am, when you sign in and when you downloaded the Minecraft code, then you have to enter your ID and then the Minecraft software will work. How I get it? Amandeep Singh sir, you will get your certificate by the clicking on the link. We will share the link so you can redeem the code and you will get the certificate. Rita ma'am, you will get the yesterday session link from where you can download the coding. Download the recording session. Now Niti ma'am has come, so she will continue the session.
Hello, everyone. Okay, so yes, so I believe like Ankita ma'am has already told or briefed you about everything, what all, like, you know, how you can download, because I was getting a number of queries. So in this case, now let me talk about, just give me a second. Okay, so now let us just talk about the session. Today's session, we will be talking. Let me open the file here. Yes, I will just let you know everything. So, we'll talk about the, just give me a second. I'll open the sheet for you. Where is just give me a second. Okay. So now, first of all, I'll just tell you about the coding, the today's coding part here. Now we have the algorithm with block coding. Fine. So yesterday we talked about the coding, like, you know, the simple coding, the block coding through Minecraft, how we can do with the help of Arcade, how we can do it. Now, the students will learn about in this chapter about the algorithm with block coding, as well as the, you can say, there are few other things that we will discuss in today's session. So first we will talk about the algorithm. So we talked about yesterday's yesterday that algorithm is defined as the step-by-step plan just to solve the problem for a given problem statement, right? And we can just give this example. Again, it's there in the resource book. So what I can do, maybe Ankita has already told you or briefed you about this link. You can just copy this link. I've already shared it in the chat window. So what you can do, you can just open the browser and you can just paste this link and then press enter. So here it is saying this site cannot be reached, maybe because here due to network problem, it's not like enabled, but it will be enabled for you when you will just open it. Here in this particular link, I have already shared. I'll just tell you what all I have shared it here. Let me just show you quickly, so that you will also not find any difficulty after this, isn't it? Because these coding sessions are in continuation. So that's why. Now, let me open this OneDrive for you all. And here I have just created this coding webinar and you will find all the day wise, you know, link. So when you click on the day one, you can open it. The day one recording, it's already there, as well as the redeem code and the feedback link, it's also there. When you go back and then you will click on the day two part where the redeem code and the feedback link, it's also there. Correct. Similarly, all the faculty handbook, project booklet, student handbook, the teacher resource PPT, it's already uploaded in this particular folder. Fine. So that's quite useful for you all. Now you need not to depend on anyone, like from where you will get it. You can just open this coding webinar resources folder and you will just find, or you can even download it from this link which we have provided. Okay, and don't worry, this link will be working fine, so do not worry about that as well. Okay, so yes, we were just talking about what is an algorithm that you need to talk about, and after that you will also be telling to them, like, you know, what all the benefits that you have using a flowchart. Find that you are already aware of, you can just tell them the pseudocode as well, what exactly the pseudocode is, and most of the symbols that we use when we create or design a flowchart. So that you need to explain them about the terminal, the input output processing, flow lines, connectors and everything. Okay, so that is also important for all of us. Now the next is getting started again with the block coding, because in today's session we'll talk about the variables, right? How we'll define the variable, how we can just show the syntaxes, because this time we need to just tell them what exactly the variable and why we use variable. Fine. So this we have already discussed, like it is a framework for creating interactive. So without wasting any time, let me open the browser here and I'll open a new blank tab here. And I'm going to open this arcade.makecode.com once again, the URL. You can even sign in with your ID that we have already discussed. Just click on this plus button. That is a new project window, right? So what I can give here, I can just give a name to it. You can, because here what we are learning the variable, what exactly the variable is, isn't it? So from the list, so first give this demo variable. Okay, so I've given a project name here. Just simply click on create button. Now from the list box that you already maybe had gone through about this interface, because we already discussed yesterday, here we have the list, complete list of all the blocks. So from variable section, just select a make a variable. So first is you need to give a variable name here. That is A. Let's say I'm going to take a variable here. So how to make a variable first of all, and why we use it, so that you need to tell them, okay, just wait. We'll tell you that why we use this particular variable. Because let's say in the previous section, you can also tell them that you just maybe created one program where you have displayed, you know, your name yesterday that we did, right? But today again, you want to use the same, or you need to display the same message, or maybe you want to store something. So where you will store it, right? So in the computer memory, if you are going to store any of the particular value, fine. So for that, what we require a variable. So that you need to tell them. And in that variable, we need to first define a value. So there are two things. One is taking a variable, and after that, we need to initialize the variable. So I have not initialized yet, but yes, I want to first define a variable that I have defined it. That is the A variable I have. Okay, now I want to initialize it. So what is that? This is like, you know, the A variable, which it is given, and the value right now it is as zero. But let's say I just drag and then drop it here. Now I want to initialize it as well. So how to initialize it? So set A to, let me just give this value as 10. Okay, so I am defining this particular value to a variable, fine. And the variable name is A here. Okay, now let's say if you want, maybe you want to take another variable from it. So eventually we can just take and define n number of variables. Okay, so first time I have taken like a variable here, that is defined that a to 10. Similarly, if you want to create another variable, let's say set b, because I just want to add two numbers, let's say. Okay, so I'll just click on this variable again, make a variable, give a variable name b, click on okay. Now b is also been added, so set. You can just drag and then drop it here. Now this time I am just giving a value to it, that is 20. Okay, so this is particularly like, you know, the variable value that I have defined it. Now you want to do some operations on it, that we all know that we have different syntaxes. You can just tell them that plus, minus. So you will find this math, in this math section, you have different operators here, right? The plus, minus, multiply, divide, remainder. So what exactly you want, basically you need to just tell them. Let's say I want to sum these, or maybe you can say that summation of these two numbers that I want. So what I'll do here, I'll just drag and then drop it here first. Okay, now what I need to define here, or what I need to give it here instead of 0 and 0, you can ask from the student what I need to sum. So shall I give the 10 and 20 again, or shall I give like A and B here? So yes, student will say, because okay, I have already saved this 10 value in this particular, or like, you know, variable, that is A. So what I'll do, I'll go to this variable section again. I'll drag and then drop it here. Okay, similarly, I will drag and then drop this B also. That comes, now you will see that you are going to sum A plus B here, right? Now, if you want, like, you know, A plus B, you can ask from the student. So after this, where the value will be saved, you know, after submission. Okay, so obviously the student will say, yes, ma'am, I just want, or we will take another variable for that, so that we will just, you know, store the summation of these two variables. So then you said, okay, I'll just go to this variable section again, make a variable, take a variable C, or you can just give a variable name, any variable name also. So you need to tell to the students that the variable name should be meaningful. So here we have, let's say, the result I have given. Click on OK. Now I have a result variable here that I have given, and I have given a meaningful name. So instead of giving C, I have defined it as result. So that is also quite OK for me. Now I want to set this particular, you know, the, I mean, summation of these two numbers, and I want to store it into the result. So what I'll do in this case, if you remember, I just used this set block here. Okay, now set result, so that we have already defined it, set result to. Now what you want? Okay, I want to set this result where the result is basically in these two variables, that is A plus B. So what I'll do, I'll just drag and then drop it here. It's quite easy. So now, yeah, it's basically one statement. This is what, this is just one statement that you have defined, that set result to A plus B. So simply I can drag and then place it here onto the start block. So probably I think this one is clear to everyone. These two are the variable, the result is the particularly, like, you know, the third variable which I have taken, and the summation is set C to A plus B. So that I have taken here. Now what I want to display here in this simulation. Okay, maybe, like, you know, in this display box. So how to display the result? That is also very important. Fine. So in this case, what we have a, because I need to show the string value also. And if you remember, we used a splash, maybe, like, you know, yesterday, just to display any of the message. But I want to combine two things here. So what do you want to combine? I want to combine this result, and also I want to combine the string value, that is the sum of two numbers. So what you will do in this case, I'll go to this advanced section, and here I have a text. OK, now in this particular text, you have one of the block here, that is the join. And when you hover your mouse, it also gives you the definition, like, you know, this block is specifically for what? It is saying that create a piece of text by joining together any number of items. OK, so let us just take this join here. Now what I want to display it here, so I want to display sum of two numbers. Yeah, so that I'm going to do this activity, sum of two numbers, and where are, like, you know, my two numbers, or maybe where is my result, basically, that I just want to display. So my result is here in this result, like, you know, variable. So what I'll do, I'll go back to the variable section, I'll take this result and then place it here, isn't it? So sum of two numbers and then result. So I have joined these two blocks together. So if you have number of items that you have and you want to join it, so for this we can use this join block as well. Okay, so that we have joined. Now if you want to display your message, so for that, you remember, I think, what we need to take, we need to go to this right here, or no, in this game, I'll just select the splash block. Yeah, so I'll just place it after this set, and you can drag and then place it here in this section. Correct? It seems good. Now you can just tell to the students that, yes, this is basically first the algorithm. What we did, we just, you know, had written few number of steps. After that, you need to just tell them that to create a flowchart. Once the flowchart has been created, after that, you need to tell them that they need to perform this activity with the help of block coding. OK, and now you would be able to see sum of two numbers, that is 30. So it's quite interesting. And yeah, I just want to add this equals to as well. OK, now here it is showing sum of two numbers is equals to 30. Quite interesting. Yes or no? Okay. So you may also, my team is there. So if you say yes, if it is interesting or any kind of feedback, if you want to give, you can type it, or you can just ping in that chat window. Great. Thank you. Okay. So once you have done this particular portion, now second, maybe, being an educator, maybe it must be coming in our mind, instead of, taking this 10, or we have already defined 10, but let's say user wants, or maybe student says, ma'am, I just want that I should select the number, or I should give the number, or we can ask the number from the user, then only I just want to do this kind of operations. So how you can tell them? So yes, we can do it with the help of what I'll do. I'll go to this the game portion over here, and we have a dialogue here that is ask for a number. Okay, because here we already defined this 10. Now we can just remove this and we can place this block here, that is ask for a number. So that's interesting. So now what it will see in this display editor window, what you see, there are few numbers. But again, one more thing, it's here because it is asking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 numbers. But I just want to add only one number here. Then what you will do in this case? So just click on this plus symbol. Okay. And so these are the arguments. Being a computer science teacher, maybe few are already aware of that. What do you mean by arguments? But still, okay. Other teachers, they may also understand that. Yes, here we need to pass two things. One is the ask for a number, and another is how many numbers you need to pass, basically. So if for the other teachers also, they may just hover their mouse and then they can just read one by one definition of it, ask the player for a number value. So here I'll just give a length. Length has, let's say, 2. Okay, 2 digits. So I'll just take it. Basically, the maximum length is 2. So ask for a number is this. Let's say the second is 20. Okay, so what I'll do here, I'll refresh the simulator. Now I need to give one number as, let's say, 1. And another number, let's say I'll take it as 10. So 20 plus 10. So the result will be what? 30. Because earlier also it was 30. So let us take the another number as 12. Maybe. Okay, or let it be 0 this time. So 10 plus 20, so output will be 30. Then you need to, how you are moving from one window to another window, by just arrow key. So simple, okay, it's there, and then press enter. So now the sum of two number is 30. Clear? If you want to execute it again, just refresh it. This time I'm going to take, let's say, 4. And I am going to take a 0 here. So 40 plus 20, this time result I'm expecting as what? You can say. So that is 60. Yeah, so the sum of two numbers, 60. Now the student will easily come to know what you mean by variable, how you are going to do some of the operations on all those variables. Because if I just open the the book, faculty handbook, which I already had shown yesterday, but still, let me just show you once again. If I just open this handbook here, and you can even Control F, you can press and then search for it, but or maybe for the activity, you will find it here also. Otherwise, the second, you can open the project booklet. Just open this, and let's say if I, here you will find your code, the same code which I am, or I have used it here for you all. See, so they have used the if else also for this. We have a class tomorrow. Do not worry, we will do about the if else condition as well. But for today, if I just scroll down a little bit more. Oh, yes, what we have here. Yeah, so this is the one of the activity, that is the dynamic backgrounds. So that also you can just use it. But this activity we have completed, or we have seen today. Fine, so you need not to worry, it's already uploaded in that link which we have shared. Okay, and after this session you can just click on it, you will find all the resources, right? And where you will get this particular activity, in this project booklet You can just open it, and this is one of the activity which we have performed just now. I hope this activity is clear to all. What do you mean by variable? How you're going to define it and how the result will be displayed? Okay. Now, the question, like, you know, it may be there in our mind, how we can do the same activity with the help of Minecraft. Yeah, because obviously we have two different platforms that we are using it. Few of the code that we have written here through Arcade, and eventually we can use the Minecraft also for this. So what I'll do, I'll just quickly open the Minecraft here for you. Okay. So I have just opened it. Let me just show you the Minecraft now. Till the time it's going to open it, you may ask your queries. So our team is also responding to you all. I believe you will not find any difficulty now. Yesterday we received n number of queries related to certificate and all the stuff. So do not worry, we are also helping you out and doing that. So let me sign in. Okay, so let me use this, I think. Okay, so I have just entered one of the ID here, the demo ID. So the same activity we can perform here through Minecraft. So let me just open the one, the play. Now, here, yesterday we seen our, seen one of the example, like, you know, chicken, fine. But that was through, the tutorial. So that we have seen. This time, let me select my world as well. You can simply click on create new as well. Similarly here, and I will click on. And then there are few templates. You can, if you just click on this, these templates are also given. Let me take, you know, blocks of grass. Why I'm going to take this? Because this is basically a plain grass where you can do a number of things. You can also do some hit and trials. You would be able to see your list and everything and click on play. Okay. So you will find a plain grass over here, where you can place all your blocks and everything. And definitely students will enjoy this activity with the help of, Minecraft. They can learn coding in a very simple manner, believe me. Okay, so I have just opened the Minecraft. So very quickly, I'll just go, I'll add few of the blocks here in a similar way that we did with the Arcade. Okay, so it's just generating the world and everything. Now you see the same window, fine. So it's a plain grass. Now you can do a number of things here. Okay, that we have already seen few of the controls. So if you remember, for coding, what we need to enter? C. So C is for the code builder. So let me open the code builder quickly. And here I will click on the new project, because yesterday we had seen this example or the tutorials of the chicken rain. Here, if you want to expand it, you can use this as well. Okay, and if you want to refresh the project, you can click on this icon as well. So this is a simple interface. So let me click on new project here. So again, I can give a project name. So same name I can give here, demo variable. Click on create. So it's just creating a new project. So now you see here also you have some list. Okay, and from these lists you can select the required, you know, blocks here as well. And if you see a convert code to JavaScript as well as the Python, again, both the things are available, but right now we are focusing on the block coding part. So now this time what I need to do, I again need to set a variable. So same kind of activity quickly we can do. It's just a recap. So I've taken a here. I'll just place it. Quickly I'll take a variable B. I'll take it. So I'm just taking the same example. Why? So that those who are new to it, they would be easily correlate okay, that what we are doing. So for the another variable, what I need to take, oh, sorry, where is that? Set B. Okay, just add it. And this time I'm going to give a variable that is result. Okay, so set result that I have just added. Now in this set result 2, again, what I need to do, I need to use that math operation, same here. So these two, I need to add A here, and I need to add a B here. Okay, it's done. So now I need to drag and then place it here. So set result 2, A plus B. So now in this case, if you want to display, you know, the same thing, the message along with the value. So value, it's there in my variable, and message I want to pass, like, you know, I mean, maybe the student wants to pass anything. So that you can tell to the students that if you want to join again these two things, one, the message that you want to pass, or that is the user defined message, you can say, plus you also want to define the value of, like, you know, this particular result variable. So what I'll do here, I have, or I'll go to these basic one, and if you just scroll down, let me see, where is my join something? Okay, so join operation here also, again, we need to go to this text. I'll just drag and then drop it here. Join. And what I want to join, simple, sum equals to. Okay, and here what I want to display, I want to display the result. So what I'll do, I'll take the result variable and then place it here. Correct. Now I want to, because we use the splash block, if you remember, just to display anything, fine. But here what we have a say block. If you want to display anything, go to this player, and here we have say. So place it and join this. Perfect. So here we have these blocks that we have just added. And on chat command that you had already seen yesterday, that if you just press, you know, the command, then your program will execute. But here, instead of run, you can also say execute. Okay, so you can just use your own message, whatever it's there in your mind, or you can even start from here as well. So if I say, I'll basically do this start button. Okay, and now you need to open the T-chat window here. And you can just type execute with this command, right? It get the code gets executed, and you'll see the output here, which is there at the top. Here it is taking as sum equals to 0. Fine. So what I can do, I can go back to the code builder again. Now here, why it is giving me 0? Because I have not defined any value to it. Okay, so I need to set the value to it. So let's say 30, and this time again, I'll keep it as 40. So answer will be what? That you all know. So what I can do, I can again click on the start button. Now you'll see at the top here, sum equals to 70. It's displaying. Yeah. So even if you just press T, you will see that this is the summation, that is sum equals to 70. Correct. So this way you can just use the simple coding with the help of Minecraft as well. It's quite interesting. So we can just stop it. And if you do further coding here, you can just do it. You can, there is an inventory, fine. And let's say you want to place a few of the block, right? Let's say you have taken one block, you have few gates, or maybe, you know, the fencing that you have just added, right? And when it's done, so let's say you are the agent here and you want to place a block here. So what I'll do here, basically, you know, for placing the block, so first number I have selected, and with the help of right click, I can just, you know, place all the blocks here, so that we can do it. One. Fine. Similarly, you can place n number of blocks here, isn't it? So it's quite interesting. But now you can just ask from the user, is it quite easy to place all the blocks, you know, one by one? Because let's say if teacher has given you one activity and you need to create a, or maybe you need to design a building or a monument or maybe any Qutub Minar or maybe any, like, you know, the historical place that you need to design, so that history will become so easy for them now. Fine. Otherwise, it's quite boring. I do remember, because here we have a blackboard, we have immersive reader, we have all the checking tools as well. Assessment tools are also there in the Minecraft. So don't worry, all these tools are there, and we will be guiding you how effectively other subject teachers can also use it. Because I just got a feedback today that how other subjects teacher, you know, can also use the Minecraft. So we are helping them, and we will also conduct some more session. Definitely we'll share the link with you all, and then you can attend these sessions as well in detail. So due to timing constraints, so that's why I'm just telling the main points here. Now you can tell to the students, because here you are just placing one block at a time. But let's say if you want to construct a building, maybe you need to place, you know, 100 blocks, 200 blocks at some position. Fine. So what you can just tell, again, you can go to the code builder here, and with the help of coding, you can, you know, place all the blocks all together as well. Okay. So that's quite interesting for you as well. You can just create a or maybe I'll just tell you, because here we have, if you want to remove all this, so you can drag and then drop it back. You can open the agent. Fine. I'll just give you only simple example here of this block. What agent needs to set here? So agent need to set the agent set block or item here. Fine. Now this time I want to set all the blocks or the items. You can select accordingly. See all the inventory like items. It's like, you know, here, or it's displaying. You can select any of the item from here, and the number of count you need to define. How many blocks you want? Let's say 30. Okay, in one slot. Let's say second slot you're going to add maybe further two different other blocks that you want. You can do it. So agent set active slot here. Again, you need to take maybe the slot, the second slot that you have taken, and this time you want like agent just a minute, place on move. Okay, and here you need to enable it as true. So it's done. And this type of activity, let's say you want to repeat it, so if you want to repeat, though the looping part we will discuss tomorrow, don't worry, but I am just using it repeat like four times, and the agent will move forward. So here it is, agent move forward by, let's say, the five steps. Okay, that we already seen yesterday. So agent, how the agent will move. Okay, and next time the agent turn towards, let's say, maybe the right or left, it's up to us. Yeah, it's done. This time I have taken a block of grass instead of this. Let me take other few example. Let me take this mushroom. What's that? And you can click on run button. So you'll see the mushroom. See one of the blocks. So it's placing all the blocks automatically. Oh, it stopped because it's just an obstacle. So that's why it's just giving you an error. So first we need to remove the first one, or we need to move further. Okay. This is a simple plain grass. I'll go back to the code, my builder. Now I can execute it again. Now you'll see in a moment. See, it has just started, you know, placing the blocks. Yeah, it is interesting. So with the help of coding, it just make your work easy. So it's saying please. Fine. So similarly, you can place n number of blocks top of the above, and with the help of coding, the student or the kids will learn automatically. Yeah. So don't worry, everything is there in the variable that we have seen, and we have also seen, like, you know, few of the example. And you can also tell them few real life examples, because we have already seen this, you know, activity, how you can validate the user input performing mathematical operations on different. You can tell them that they can do the activity on their own, and then they can do the variable initialization, then the declaration. You can just tell them one by one. Fine. So this is one of the example here where you are just storing n number of values, that is digit as well as the string. OK, and then we can tell them the data types, because we do have then being a computer science teacher, you're already aware of, like we have different data types like integer, floating, string, boolean. You can tell them the real life example that if you have maybe you want to store the age. Fine. So for that, which data type that you will pick or you will take, that is obviously the integer. Similarly, for a string where like the address, because address contains the integer and the number, you can say alphabets as well. So if you have the combination of both, so in those cases we can take string. So you can tell them the boolean when we have a answer like, you know, based on true and false. So you can just tell them all these stuff. So it's there in the PPT. You can go through the math operation. We have just seen how to add, subtract, multiplication. You can give the activity. It's there in the book also, project booklet. So students will perform on their own. You need not to worry, because one you have already shown, that is the addition. Rest of them, they will do like subtraction, and they can combine all these things as well. OK, so. This is just same that we have discussed. So this activity we have completed. So I hope today's session is also like, you know, quite interesting for you all. And Ankita ma'am, she is also sharing the same code with you all, as well as the feedback link. Fine. So you can particularly copy and then paste it, even though if that chat is not accessible, we will share this particular OneDrive link. Ankita, if you can just please share the OneDrive link once again. So you can open this, okay? And you can open this, fine? So here you will find the day two folder. When you open the day two folder, you will find this Word document here. And when you open this Word document, all these steps are also being given, fine? So you will not find difficulty, I think, after this, because yesterday I received n number of messages and like, you know, the calls as well. Or maybe like this time, I don't think that you will find any difficulty. So here in this day two, though Ankita ma'am has already shared it, yes, you can also refer this document. In this day two, where we have already defined the achievement code that you can achieve and the feedback link. Okay, so now I am coming back. Anything, any question, any query? So please, you may drop out here. You may drop your query here. And how was the session today? I just want a feedback, like, you know, as a live feedback in this question and answer chat window. So please, you may drop a message here. The block coding, how simple it is for the students. Yes. Okay. Perfect. So link Ankita ma'am has already shared. Okay. Thank you. Anything else, like if you have any doubt or any query related to the block coding? So we have already provided the ID to you all. And though I will be quite busy in the trainings and as well, so I am going to share the numbers of my team member. Just a minute. Where is that? Let me open it for you. Okay. Yeah, here it is. So you may note down both the IDs as well as the number. So it's there. Now you can even drop a message on these, any of the numbers. So Mr. Shyam and Ms. Ankita, they are also there just to support you. OK, so let's connect or remain connect, like, you know, so that we will resolve all your queries well on time. Thank you, everyone. Have a great day ahead. Do not forget to give the feedback. Or maybe anything, if you want to Share the field. The link is working now. Okay, great. Some of you, please help us to understand how to sign in Minecraft. Okay, if somebody is asking, like, you know, how to sign in the Minecraft, so that is quite easy because some of these schools, they are already using the Minecraft licenses, isn't it? So these licenses, like, you know, are available. You can approach to us also. Apart from that, trial version is also there. What you can do, you can simply open the browser. I'm just telling you these steps. In case if you have any difficulty, you may do it or maybe you can just open it here. Let me open this. What I'll do, I'll just write it here. The education.minecraft.net. Okay. So this link, you need to open it. Right, and it's easy to download it. No need to worry. So Ankita ma'am, if you can just please copy this link as well, and then you can paste it in the chat window again. Yeah, so here we have a download option. So when we click on this download, okay, and when you click on it, so simply you need to click on this option, that is download now. When you click on this download now, the .exe file will be downloaded. You need to just provide the where you want to store or where you want to save. So you need to tell the location, and once it's downloaded, this is the executable file. Just double click on it and then it will get executed. Once it's downloaded, let me close this. Okay, so once it's downloaded, you need to just open it. And you can sign in with the Office 365 ID if you have. And if you have the personal ID like Hotmail or maybe the Outlook that you are using, for that you must be getting the trial version, you know, 25 like for educators. So you will get the trial licenses and then you can probably do that. Okay, so because mine is like one of the ID that I was using here, so it's saying that your trial of Minecraft is completed. So either your school or the whole organization, you can buy these licenses. So this way you can just go there. But yes, the trial version is already there, and most of the schools or the educators, they are already using MS Teams, isn't it? So and they must be having their IDs also, M365. So you can just log in with that M365 ID and you will get again the free attempts of accessing this Minecraft. Yeah, so I hope now it is clear how to use or download the Minecraft. Okay. Thank you. So session was good, excellent. Thank you for the wonderful session. I'm so happy for the feedback. Might be if it is too fast for few of the faculty members. I really sorry for that, because within this 1 hour, I have to complete, you know, most of the topics. So that's why. So you can go through the recording, because I will upload the recording as well, right? So do not worry if I'm too fast here. So what you can do, you can go back and then you can do the recap of this, I mean, today's session. Okay, so very interesting to learn block coding. Great, thank you. Okay, so finally, I'm just going to end the webinar for all of us, and let's connect on WhatsApp or maybe, on Teams for further query. Thank you, have a great day ahead. Bye-bye.